We're carrying out a reconnaissance mission in order to obtain photographs of the enemy complex. After deciphering the code we received earlier, we've learned that the mining facility in the forest area northwest of Belka is active. An early warning radar network has been spread across the entire forest. To reduce the probability of enemy detection, this mission will be carried out by a single aircraft. Try to approach the target under complete electronic silence, evading radar and passive search techniques. Flying at low altitude is an effective method of delaying or denying enemy detection. You will receive instructions on your recon target from the Command Information Center upon arriving in the mission area. The CIC will monitor you from a support camera. Concentrate on slipping through the enemy radar net first. Your plane in this mission will be completely stripped of weaponry. Instead, it will be equipped with the necessary visual reconnaissance equipment. There is a chance you may encounter the enemy, but your recon mission always takes top priority. Once you take the photos, egress from the target area and return through the enemy defenses as directed.
How you feeling? Solo flights can be real lonely, but that's what flying's all about, really. Take a look at your search radar. The enemy's radar range is marked out by those circles. Make sure you don't enter any of those circles, and fly to the east. The enemy radar's coverage area is smaller at low altitude. You want to see it for yourself? Anyway, radar coverage areas will be displayed on your search radar, so keep your eyes on it. This is strictly a recon mission, so you will be unarmed. So unfortunately, you won't be able to destroy the enemy radar. Sorry. Maintain radio silence until you reach the destination. I'll then explain the target and how to photograph it. Got it? Make sure you don't get caught within coverage area of the enemy radar. Good luck. Go into radio silence in a moment. Hang in there till the next transmission. monitoring your status with a low-resolution camera. Something's being moved from the mine entrance to that transport plane. Okay, let's get a photo with the mine entrance and the transport plane in the frame. The camera's triggered by the missile launch button. Press it to take a picture.
The recon mission in the mining facility was a success. The images taken. Analysis of the surveillance photos taken on the previous mission revealed tactical nuclear weapons of the same type used by Belka in the war 15 years ago. These weapons, hidden in the mine, are about to be retrieved and deployed to the two aggressor squadrons in Osia and Yuktobania. The President has made his decision. Destroy the entrance to the mine before the next nuclear weapon is removed from the shaft, and bury those weapons of evil inside for good. This mission will be carried out with the usual four-ship formation. You'll need powerful and numerous weapons on target to destroy the rock face above the entrance.
Captain, please choose my plane.
Captain, please choose a plane for me to pilot.
Captain, which plane should I use?
This formation is not really suited for air-to-ground operations. Do you still want to launch anyway?
Rosgreaves, launch!
Blaze, you are cleared for takeoff. Altitude restrictions canceled. Return to your mission. Good luck.
Today will be easy since we don't have to worry about any radar. Right, Captain? I'm sorry, I should know better. I can't believe the captain flew around this place all by himself. Just thinking about those nukes that are buried up ahead gives me the goosebumps.
Those nukes are exactly why the Belkans have lured themselves to sneaking around, pitting two countries against each other. You give a man enough weapons, he'll start to think he's more powerful than he really is. Of course, it's beyond me how these people could delude themselves into thinking they could control the very weapon which wiped out their own cities.
I'm sick of seeing all this hatred everywhere we go. We can't let those nukes reach the battlefield and fuel more hate. We won't let it happen.
How you doing, Blaze? I tell you, nothing beats flying in perfect formation with your comrades. In the past, I flew alone to do battle against my own country. You've got all your friends here. Don't you think so?
Yep, it's a great feeling to know that you can count on each other.
They're carrying an emblem I've never seen before.
Enemy plane spotted. All units, prepare for air-to-air combat.
Roger, Meteor 2. I see them over here, too.
Send out a warning to vessels docked at the port.
Drop the moorings or they'll all be sunk together.
To tell you the truth, the thought of nuclear weapons just terrifies me. they've already carried out nuclear weapons?
Blaze, it's too soon to give up. There may still be something we can do.
Thanks for carry out.
Are the nukes still inside that mine?
They gotta be, seeing as the enemy's still trying to protect it.
Sealed in those nukes.
But there are more Belkan nukes out there.
Mission accomplished. Thanks to that rock avalanche, the mine entrance is now sealed off, and the tactical nukes have been removed as a threat to the world. Intel has lost track of the nukes they already removed, but it is certain that the weapon sealed in the mine shaft will never be deployed.
We've intercepted another mysterious radio transmission. This time, it specifies a location within Yuktobania. It's probably... well, this is just a hunch on my part, but I bet that's where the nuclear weapon sent into Yuktobania is located. And there's another set of numbers. This time it's a radio frequency.
Your next mission is a reconnaissance flight above a canyon in the northern highlands of Yuktabania, the place described in the unidentified radio transmission. The highlands are completely covered by the Yuktabania air defense system, so the only safe place to fly is within the canyon itself. Fly down the canyon and reach the target area. Once you're there, set your radio channel to the directed frequency and begin gathering information. You may be engaged by local Yuktabanian forces, and depending on the contents of the transmission, you may also find yourself engaging in other combat as well. You are permitted to fight the enemy as necessary, but you must try to keep your altitude below the rim of the canyon.
Captain, please choose my plane.
Captain, please choose a plane for me to pilot.
Captain, which plane should I use?
Is this the formation you want?
We're launching to this formation then?
Signals as well. Can you hear this?
Who are you? Identify yourself.
A great number of students and intellectuals are staging a resistance against the military government of Yuktabania. You can call me Alyosha. That's not my real name, of course. I'm so glad you actually came. It's just like he said.
He?
We have no time. Let me explain the situation.
We've received contact from an apparent resistance group that seized and captured one of Yuktabania's nuclear weapons. Intelligence believes that it's one of the nukes taken from the mine before we sealed it off on the 12th. Furthermore, our radar has detected numerous enemy fighters entering the canyon and flying towards the local airspace. The force includes Yuktabanian fighters and armed helicopters. Their mission is most likely to destroy the resistance's hideout. The enemy fighters are spread out throughout the canyon, so we believe that the Yuktabanians still don't have the exact location of the hideout. Destroy the enemy forces before they can find and wipe out the resistance. As mentioned previously, the local space is blanketed by Yuktabania's air defense system. Watch your altitude, and whatever you do, don't fly above the rim of the canyon.
Physics graduate student from Yuktabania Central University is currently dismantling the nuclear bomb so that it can never be detonated again. We need you to hold off the Yuktabanian forces from entering the ravine until he finishes the task.
This is going to be a real test of our flying ability. Let's do our best.
It feels like the clip is closing in on us. Flying here is nearly impossible, don't you think so? Well, sure, maybe you're all right, but
all they have are helicopters, then we can take them on.
We're now dismantling the nuclear bomb. This is a pretty tiny bomb. Maybe it's a tactical nuke. Hard to believe something like this could wipe out an entire city.
Don't let the helicopters approach the canyon.
I'm just praying they don't blow up that thing by accident. This is Variant 4. We've sanitized the drop point.
He? Someone who knows us? Could it be?
Negative. We're restricted by the terrain here.
Let's start with that cave.
Outside at bay? That's great. We better do our best, too.
HQ to Special Forces. Report your status. This is Special Forces. There's no one here.
I don't see anyone here. Have they already escaped?
Hurry up and find them. We have no idea what they're up to.
Circus!
What? You mean it's gonna...
Oh, no, never mind. It's fine. We shut it off.
Oh, okay.
It's pitch black. Give me a night scope.
This thing won't be set off by an enemy attack, will it?
This room, it's all over for us.
We have a terrain advantage. Don't rush. This is Variant 2. Our squads are being cut off from each other. HQ to all Variant squads. Report. Nothing yet. Every place we searched was empty.
Anything. This stuff.
them?
This is Avnir 1. I said that's what I heard. The ghosts of the demons of Rosgrees.
You're kidding me. They all sunk to the bottom of the ocean. Didn't the guys from Grabot tell you that?
We'll find out if they're ghosts or not when we take them on in combat.
Guys from the surveillance photo.
Be careful. Remember what Pop said. These guys are Belkan aces.
Omnir fighters! So they're the Uke aggressors? Damn it. Of all the places, I feel like they're hunting us like animals.
Omnir squadron, flying through this ravine is extremely dangerous.
Shot down. Looks like the other enemy forces bugged out on us, too.
Okay. We've dismantled the bomb. Did you fend off the enemy forces for us?
For now.
We're going into the ocean to discard the bomb piece by piece. Nobody will ever be able to use it as a weapon again. If you can, please protect us until we make it into the ocean.
We will. But what about...
Don't be surprised, but our ship? It's a submarine. There's nothing we can't get our hands on. I told you, we have a lot of allies.
All right. But who told you that we'd definitely be coming for you?
I don't know his name. But he left a message for your captain. I'll read it. It says, "Hey kid, I hear you're a hell of a squad captain now. Do you get it?"
Yes, perfectly.
Mission accomplished. The information we obtained, as well as the physical damage we caused, dealt a significant blow to the enemy. Judging by our analysis of the information, there appears to be a highly organized resistance force acting against the Yuktabanian military regime. it is likely the nuclear weapon which Yuktovania acquired was safely dismantled by the Resistance. The intelligence vessel Andromeda has picked up another encrypted transmission in Belkin. They have changed the code, so it took a little longer to decipher the message. The content is as follows. N attack by ASAT on Okhchabrsk to commence at 1400 hours. Apparently, efforts to secretly repair the sabotaged Arkbird are now complete. We confirmed this by observing its orbit from the ground. We believe that a Belkin nuke has already been loaded onto the Arkbird. In order for the Arkbird to attack the city of Okhchabrsk in Yuktovania at 1400 hours, it must make one major correction to its orbital trajectory. To do this, it must first drop into the upper atmosphere and use air friction to lower its speed. We have already calculated the time and location in which this maneuver will occur. Your mission is to destroy the Arkbird. You will only have one chance to stop it. Destroy it before it withdraws from the battle zone.
Captain, please choose my plane.
Captain, please choose a plane for me to pilot.
Captain, which plane should I use? We're launching with this formation then?
Roscrees, launch!
We were so close. I feel like the Belkins are always one step ahead. Don't you, Captain?
Still, Blaze, we can't give up now. We haven't run out of luck just yet. Let's go!
I can see it now, Nagase.
Yeah.
It'll be tough reaching that altitude. Hey, is everything okay?
What do you mean? Wait, the Arkbird! It just jettisoned something.
It's an escape capsule.
Adler to Shansei. He got away.
The Ocean astronaut?
Yeah. It's all right. We don't need him anymore. Oh, damn it. He must have done something to the control system before he got away. Turn off that switch. Damn, we're slowing down. We're gonna dive deep into the atmosphere.
Captain, this is Archer. Doesn't the Arkbird's approach path seem too deep? Its altitude is too low for an orbit change. That white bird was a symbol of hope for Captain Nagase.
And now, she must try to shoot it down.
I'm in attack position. Awaiting orders.
Who the hell?
Right, Vogels. That envelope. It's them.
so close. I feel like the Belkans are always one step ahead. Don't you, Captain? I know, Captain. I haven't given up either. I can see it now, Nagase.
Yeah.
It'll be tough reaching that altitude. Hey, is everything okay?
What do you mean? Wait, the Ark Bird! It just jettisoned something.
It was an escape capsule.
Adler to Shansei. He got away.
Captain, this is Archer. Doesn't the Ark Bird's approach path seem too deep? No, there is definitely something wrong with it. Its altitude is dropping as well. That white bird was a symbol of hope for Captain Nagase.
And now, she must try to shoot it down.
I'm in attack position, awaiting orders.
Reaching that altitude. Hey, is everything okay?
What do you mean? Wait, the Ark Bird! It just jettisoned.
Captain, this is Archer. Doesn't the Ark Bird's approach path seem too deep?
Archer, this is Edge. I agree with your observation. This is just what we need to shoot it down.
That white bird was a symbol of hope for Captain Nagase.
And now, she must try to shoot it down.
I'm in attack position, awaiting orders.
Watch my six, please.
Multiple unmanned fighters! They're coming this way!
backup plan, right?
I know.
Your sacrifice will never be forgotten.
We succeeded in halting the Arkbird's nuclear attack on the city of Okhchabrsk in Yuktovania. The Arkbird crashed into the middle of the Saras Ocean after attempting to detonate the nuke above Osea. Miraculously, there were no ships near the area of the crash site. According to our investigation team, there is currently no evidence of radiation fallout in the area.
The President broadcast his voice repeatedly in an effort to reveal the truth to his citizens and soldiers. However, the central government, now run by the Vice President and his generals, censored all of it, calling it enemy propaganda, and Yuktovania their enemy. wasn't about to stop fighting either. The president needed to enter the capital himself with his marine force. But that meant risking his life. As he boarded the helicopter, the president smiled and said, "Here goes." The third encrypted message from Bartlett came shortly after. This time, there were no coordinates. All it showed was a time and a radio frequency. At the appointed time, everyone gathered in front of the radio speaker.
Hey, it's me! Get the wax out of your ears and listen up. We found Nicanor, the leader of Yuktabania, and we broke him out of prison. This war wasn't his doing at all.
Captain Bartlett has rescued Prime Minister Nicanor of Yuktabania. He plans to attack an airfield in northeast Yuktabania, steal an airplane, and then escape with the Prime Minister. First, go to the directed area and wait for contact from Captain Bartlett. He'll likely have you support him as he forces his way into the airfield. More mission details will be supplied to you upon arriving at the local airspace. Threat status in the area of operation is unclear, so prepare your flight for the possibility of threats from both the ground and the air.
Captain, please choose my plane.
Captain, please choose a plane for me to pop.
Captain, which plane should I use?
I'm not sure about this formation.
Rosgrease, launch!
It's me. I'm okay so far. And the car's hidden under a bush. Other resistance members are hidden all over the place. I still got a bad feeling about this. We're storming the gate at 0705 hours. Keep us covered. I'm counting on you. I think there's gonna be an ambush waiting for us.
According to Captain Bartlett's information, the resistance has already infiltrated the airfield and is currently awaiting his arrival. The road to the airfield is covered with checkpoints and defensive positions. We anticipate stiff resistance. Provide close air support for Captain Bartlett's charge, give him aerial reconnaissance as necessary, and guide him to the airfield. The resistance has already agreed on a time to begin operations with Captain Bartlett, so the timing of the mission cannot be changed. If you do not arrive in time, the resistance will be suppressed by the airfield defense forces and the mission will end in failure. After arriving, the resistance will load Prime Minister Nicanor onto a captured transport plane and Captain Bartlett will attempt to escape. You must help Captain Bartlett arrive at the airfield on time, no matter what.
Is there someone else in the car?
Me?
bases. Take the shorter way and face heavy attacks, or take the safer route, which takes more time.
Hey kid, which route looks better to you? Should I take the shorter one? Okay, I'll bust through the shortcut.
They're going through there?
He told me all about you guys. Kid, Chopper, and, Nagase. Hey, Nagase.
Caselli, is the Prime Minister all right?
He's regaining consciousness. They injected him with some kind of drug.
Hey, don't be showing those legs too much. It's distracting.
I assume you fly your plane the same way you drive? But no loop-de-loops, please.
Yeah.
Attacking.
taking too many risks.
Hey, Nagase, you're starting to sound like my mom.
Airfield operations will begin in 5 minutes.
Kid, you take care of providing top cover. Like this in ages.
It's a little dusty.
Get the safety belt.
tight on the Prime Minister.
Keep from damaging the base as much as possible. Enemy planes overhead! They're coming right for us! Man, those guys have guts.
I want to get airborne before the runway is blocked.
How exciting! Now we have an air battle.
Incoming aircraft. Looks like bad guys to me. The 8492nd.
The long-lost Belkin Grabok fighter squadron, huh? Concentrate. That's it. Now.
Edge, Fox 2!
6 o'clock. I need cover.
We'll just wait for the next opportunity to meet again.
Look at the way the captain moves. So that's how an ace pilot flies.
Blaze just keeps surprising me. He's getting better every second.
Looks like you got them all, but the bastards all bailed out. I gotta admit, those guys are true fighter pilots.
We'll be back. You can count on it.
The 8492nd Squadron, or the Belkan Grabok Squadron to be more exact, has been annihilated. Yuktabanian Prime Minister Nicanor is also safe. Mission accomplished.
He had returned once more. He brought Nicanor, the Prime Minister of Yuktabania, with him. And surprisingly, he had brought one more person. A female recon major in the Yuk Army. The one who broke his heart 15 years ago. It became clear why nobody could find him in the POW camps. The very first POW of the war. He had escaped before they could even get him into the camps. Yuktabania's situation was just like ours. Their leader, who espoused reconciliation, was imprisoned after a silent coup d'etat, and the country proceeded to march right into large-scale war. What should I call you?
Just Major.
What's your real name? All she did was return a smile. She remained faithful to the Prime Minister and to his vision of peace. And that faith had brought her here. She was carrying a single disc. She told us that the disc contained the secret plans of the Belkan Greymen. So far, we have been unable to decipher the encryption code.
The Solg. A military attack satellite that your country began building during the war 15 years ago, then abandoned in the peace that followed. The Arkbird was reborn partly to resurrect that dreadful star. Now, even after the Arkbird was destroyed, the Space Center's mass driver is still launching supplies into orbit. What is that star receiving from them?
Thank you.